When you consider Hashem as a father, as a mother, He will be next to you.
Imagine a big yeshiva of 24,000 talmidim, students, 12,000 chavrutot. I can't even imagine what kind of yeshiva we are talking about. You go to Israel today, you will see big yeshivot, you may find there 600, 700 people, students studying Torah. But 24,000, I don't know, a lot of times I was wondering, I was thinking, how much food they had to eat? Just imagine how much food they had to eat. I know I have a yeshiva in Ashdod. I know each day there is a big lorry, big car came with food. And there is only 150 bachurim, 150 students. But here we are talking about 24,000 students. Where did they sleep? What did they eat? The food and the weather in Eritrea is very hot. Water, how? And for many years I had this question in my mind. Until I saw the Pirkei Avot. The Pirkei Avot said, "Pat b'melach tochal, b'mishirat ishti, v'al aris tishan, v'yemetach ha'osei chen, ashrecha ba'olam hazeh, v'tov lach l'chayi olam haba." See, the Pirkei Avot said that arita mit hacham, his food should be just a little bit of bread, pat b'melach, with a little bit of salt, and a little bit of water, and to sleep on the floor. So we are talking here about 24,000 students of Rabbi Akiva. So all the students, among them, there was Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Rabbi Meir Alanes, and another Frid Tzadikim. Just imagine Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. What did he eat during 13 years in the growth, in the Me'ara, when he hid himself from the Roman? He ate nothing with Rabbi Elazar. It's a little bit of fruit, dry fruit, karuvim, dry, not a kilo of fruit, just a little bit to maintain their body. Here, Rabotai was talking about 24,000 students, big tzaddikim, that really they did not eat nothing. Or their inyan, they were always, all the time, just, so they had no problem where to sleep because they sleep on the floor. They had no problem to eat. They had their own bottle of water, maybe it lasts for the week. They had a little piece of bread. So a little bit of piece of bread, it's nothing. It's not a fridge. It's not a big space where to hide food. We're talking here a big, but with all this ma'alot, with all this this level that the Talmid of Rabbi Akiva, they were, so we do not understand how they were die, how they die. They die. They were punished. From Pesach to Shavuot, 24,000 of them pass away. That way we don't shave. That way there is no smachot, no music, nothing. Because we're talking here about 24,000 Jews, big tzaddikim, like Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, Rabbi Meir Bar Alanes. What it was their problem, why they were punished, and the Gemara said, because they were big tzaddikim, and they did not respect one the other. And the last week, when I was in France, I asked a question. I said, how can we imagine the tzaddikim like the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva, the student, that they did not manage themselves? Why? How come that Chas v'Shalom, they did not respect each other? The reason is that, of course, they respected each other. Of course, they loved each other. Here we are talking about the student, the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva, and Rabbi Akiva teach his Talmidim, "Ve'ahavta le'recha kamocha," ze klal gadol b'Torah. Love your neighbor, love your friend, This is the base of Torah. Because, באמת, to be a Ben Torah, to be religious, to be a Jew, you must know that to be a Jew, there is a condition. What the condition to be a Jew? You must love the other. Because Hashem, when He gave the Torah to Am Israel, He did not give them the Torah till they were all together. Vayahan ha'am negedahar. The Jewish camp in the front of the mountain of Sinai, and as she said, Belev echad ki yesh echad, they were like one person. Can you imagine? They were like, we're talking about a few million Jews, and we're talking about one person. So just imagine, we're talking about millions of Jews, they were in the desert, and then we're talking about one person. It's impossible to imagine one person. To be millions of Jews, it's possible. Well, how it's possible? If we all we believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because the main reason, if I'm a Jew, because the Torah, it's impossible for us to respect the old Torah. It's impossible. Impossible. It's but when there is Ahdut, when there is united, when Am Israel are together, what I cannot do, you do. What you cannot do, you do. Like a mitzvah to get divorced. Can you imagine? It's a mitzvah to get divorced. So what? We will divorce? Then, maybe it's impossible. But if a Jew divorces well with all the halachot, so we share his mitzvah all together. The same way that we can share the mitzvot all together, we can as well share averot all together. Chas v'shalom. If a man do avera, I can be punished because of somebody in Australia did a avera. Because there is din of arvut. Am Israel arevi zibezi. Am Israel, they are all united. When we do mitzvot, we are united. And we are doing avot chas v'shalom, we are united. That's why Rabotai, the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva, of course, they love each other. Vadai, there is no doubt about it, that they were big tzaddikim, and they respected what Rabbi Akiva teach them, that love your neighbor is the base of the Torah, because you cannot be a good Jew without being united. Of course, but there was only one problem. You know what the problem was? The only way I find, I have a lot of reasons, but one of the things I was thinking about last week, it was like we're talking here about 24,000 students. Listen to this, huh? We're talking here a big bit midrash there in Eretz Israel. Can you imagine from Ashdod to Yavne? It is 12 kilometers. Can you imagine 12 kilometers, the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva were sitting and learning Torah with one problem. The only problem is, no, tell me what chidush you had today. You know, Rabotai, there is a klal, there is something that you should know. When you walk to the Beit HaMidrash, as soon as you walk to the Beit HaMidrash, the atmosphere, the kiddushah of the Beit HaMidrash connects you with the Torah. Now, you did not open yet the book. You did not open the book yet. Just you come to the Beit HaMidrash and you see books. Only by coming to the Beit HaMidrash, the kiddushah, the hashpa'ah, the kiddushah that there is in the Beit HaMidrash, it connects you directly with the Torah, and then you can have a chiddush. You can have a good thought about to understand the pasuk, to understand something. You know, Bemet, when I see a Jew, a good Jew, I have a chidush. So, because a Jew should always be connected to Hashem, to the Torah. We are married, we have children. My children are in France. But in my mind, I see them all the time. I even that they are in France, and I am in America. But I know, I have children there, so always they are in my mind. Do we have the same thought about Hashem? Shiviti Hashem li'igdi tamid. Each one here is married. Each one here has a business. Our mind is on the business. When we love something, our mind is focusing that on that thing, will of Hashem, do our mind is on, with Hashem. This is a problem. This is a big problem, because maybe one day, after 120 years, one question HaKadosh Baruch Hu will ask us, have you been connected to me all your life? I will tell him yes. He will tell me, I'll show you that you were not. You were more with your involved with your wife, children, family, business, friends, holidays, and with me, only one person, on Yom Kippur. And even all, not the whole of Yom Kippur. And he can prove it to you. So my friend, the only way that HaKadosh Baruch Hu can help us to be connected to him, through faces that we see, through connections, through loving each other, that can connect you to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, because in each Jew, there is a neshama. On each Jew, there is something of Hashem on him. So on each Jew, I can see Hashem. Every Jew has a neshama, has a soul. And this soul is a part of Hashem. So that means we can see Hashem every minute, every second. We can feel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And of course, the Torah Kedusha. Through the Torah. And I think the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva, the mistake that they did, because they were always only together. Each one he has his own Havruta. And they were sitting together. And there were 24,000 Jews, 24,000 Talmidim among them. And there must be a lot of chidushim. I mean, if each one will go to the other, no, tell me, how did you understand this? And he will tell him. Can you know, my friend, when you study Torah with somebody, you will understand more Torah. And if you study Torah with another somebody in the yeshiva, you ask this one, and this discussion between among Talmidim, you can understand the subject that you learn in many ways. And because each person, he was only with his friend, he only see his friends, so they saw, they feel less HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And because they feel less HaKadosh Baruch Hu, they were punished. They did not study Torah as they should study Torah. Because, as I told you, to study Torah, I remember Rav Shach Alav Shalom, even my Rosh Yeshiva, Shalit Rav Kaufman, my Rosh Yeshiva. I remember the Yeshiva, when I was in the Yeshiva, they used to go from table to table. No, how did you understand this? No. And you, how did you understand this? And you, how did you understand this? Behemet, through doing that, the Rosh Yeshiva himself, he will understand the subject more times than he did understand it before. This is the koach of the Torah. The more you study Torah with Havruta, with people, with students, you will understand the Torah more. There is a rabbi who said, a big Tana, he said, I have rabbis. I learned a lot from my rabbis, but from my Talmidim, I learn more. From my students, I learn more. Why? Because for the rabbi, you listen. That's it. But for the Talmidim, they will ask you a question. You answer them. Then they will ask you a question. Then you answer them. Then they will ask you a question. So you understand the Torah more and more with Chavruta. And I think today it's Pesach Shini. Today it's another Pesach. It's not a coincidence, Hashem Shalom. But today is the Hilul of Rabbi Meir Alanes. And Pesach Sheni, the second Pesach, that means those Jews, listen to this, those Jews that they were in the desert, that they could not do the sacrifice of Pesach because they were impure, because the covenant of Pesach, to do it, you have to be pure. And if you are tamei, if you are impure, you cannot do it. So they couldn't do it. It was 1 year after the exit of Egypt. They couldn't do it. And Korban Pesach, the sacrifice of Pesach, it means a lot to the Jews. It means a lot because that reminds them that when they went in the desert, that when they were in Egypt, they killed in front of the Egyptian their Avodah Zarah. Who could believe, who could dream 1 minute to kill the Avodah, because the Egyptian, their god, their veneration was the sheep. You know, cows, animals, And the Jews, they took those animals and they did shechita in front of them. And the Egyptians couldn't do nothing. They were just watching and they were angry. But they couldn't do nothing. That was a bigness. And the Jews in the desert, they will never forget that miracle. And now they are impure. Now they want to do the sacrifice, but they are impure. They cannot do it. So they were very, very sad. They went to Moshe Rabbeinu. They said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, so we are impure. It's not our fault that we are impure. So because we are impure, we cannot do the sacrifice. Please, Moshe, give us an idea. Help us. Please listen to this. Moshe Rabbeinu, he said, I have no answer for you, but I will ask Hashem. Every year, I reach this story. I feel a lot of emotion. Can you imagine Moshe Rabbeinu telling them, I will ask Hashem. That means that Moshe Rabbeinu, he could ask Hashem any time he wants. He can talk to Hashem like a friend. Somebody who wants to see me, well, or somebody wants to go to see a king, he must do an appointment. And to see a king, sometimes he could take, just imagine, you want to see the President Obama. You think you can call him, hello President, I'm here, I want to see you. Do you think he will see you? Maybe you have to wait 10 years to see you. Unless if you are a king or a prime minister. But just like that, you cannot see. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the king of the kings. Moshe Rabbeinu, he can talk to him any minute he wants. And he said to the Bnei Israel, I'll ask Hashem. He will give me an answer. So he asked Hashem, no, Hashem, Ribbono Shel Olam, can you tell, what answer can I tell them? They are impure and they couldn't do the Korban Pesach, and now they reclaim Korban Pesach. What can I tell them? And Hashem, he gave him an answer. He told him, and the day, like today, the 14th, yes, today, the 14th of Iyar, 1 month after Pesach, they can do Korban, the sacrifice. They have 1 day, like Pesach. They will eat matzot, they will, we give them a chance. So please, I was thinking, imagine those people, those impure people, they will not ask Moshe Rabbeinu. What would happen today? You know what? There'll be no Korban Pesach. There'll be no Korban. Maybe there will be Pesach Sheni, but who was the cause that this Pesach Sheni happened? Those impure people that they ask. You see, when you ask, you get an answer. When you ask, you get an answer. So this is, it's a big coincidence or no coincidence, we're talking about the Hilula of Rabbi Meir Alanis today. What happened to his friends, 24,000 students? They die. Why they die? Because they did not ask. They did not cancel. They did not ask each other. If they ask each other, they will understand more Torah. Like those people. If they would not ask Moshe, what's going to happen today? We are impure, so we cannot do Korban Pesach. Give us a solution. If they would not ask Moshe Rabbeinu in the Beit HaMidrash, I'm sure they were sitting and they were learning Torah. And suddenly, some impure people, hey, Moshe Rabbeinu, yes, we have a problem. What? Everybody did the Korban Pesach, not us. Why? Why didn't do it? Because I was impure. We'll ask Hashem. You understand? When Chavruta, when we all sit together, we study Torah, always there is questions on the Torah. And we need answers. And answers only through when everybody comes to the Beit HaMidrash. And this is, Rabotai, where the students, our duty today is to spread the Torah all over the world. Wherever a Jew lives, he should spread the Torah. Wherever you live, you have to show yourself you're a Jew. You represent HaKadosh Baruch Hu. This is our duty in this world, to spread אין עוד מלבדו. There is only HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There is no one else. Only HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So, Chas v'Shalom, if we don't spread the Torah, it's no good for us. And we learn this from the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva. They learned Torah. Of course they learned. They were big tzaddikim. They were in a big yeshiva. They did not eat. They only eat a piece of bread, a little bit of water they drink, and they sleep on the floor. They did not eat. They sleep. So there was not a lot of money to spend. Rabbi Akiva, he was the Rosh Yeshiva. It did not cost him nothing, this yeshiva. So what happened? Why did they die? So they're tzaddikim. Yes. Why did they die? Because they did not spread the Torah among them. Because among them, each one studied the Torah with the other one. But they did not study the Torah between them. Each one will ask the other one, tell me da. And because they did not do that, it seemed like there was no kavod between them. Each one wanted to keep his Torah for himself. He didn't want to spread the Torah to others. And the consequence of this, it was that they were punished. And we learn from what happened today. Today is Pesach Sheni. Look, if those people that they were in the Beit HaMikdash of Moshe Rabbeinu, if they would not ask Moshe, what about us today? What about us? Can't we do Korban Pesach? And Moshe Rabbeinu gave it. Say, ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave him an answer. So you see, when you enter Beit HaMidrash, always there is a question. As long as you enter Beit HaMidrash, Hashem will give you, there is a Hashefa, there is a Hashpa, there is something in the air of Beit HaMidrash, because it's Beit HaMidrash, it's like Har Sinai. I repeat, each Beit HaMidrash, it's like Har Sinai. You feel HaKadosh Baruch, you feel the Torah. There is something. Then automatically, HaKadosh Baruch will open your mind, you open your eyes, to understand more and more and more. But only if there is Havruta, if there is Torah, if there is student, and each one help the other one. But if Chas v'Shalom, there is no help. So Chas v'Shalom, there is less kavod to the Torah, and because there is less kavod to the Torah, so it could be dangerous. That way Hachamim use Lo Nahagu Kavod Zebeze. What that means, Lo Nahagu Kavod Zebeze? They did not, because each Jew represents Hashem. Each Jew represents the Torah of Hashem. If I respect you, so I respect your Torah. I respect Hashem that He is in you. But if I don't respect you, so I don't respect your Torah, and I don't respect the Hashem that He is on you. And because each one was sitting in a place without care about the other one, they were punished. And look, my friend, the Jews today, they care about the mitzvah. Because they couldn't do Korban Pesach, they care. They said, what about us? So they want, they ask, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us a mitzvah because of them. So my friend, be careful. If you have a question and you don't ask, because if you ask, there will be an answer that you will be born. So who is the cause of this answer? Who was born? You. Because you ask, but if you didn't ask, it would be a problem. I finish, just to tell you something, a small story. It was a rabbi, he did not understand the Tosfot. He did not understand one Tosfot. For 40 days he fasted. He did not eat for 40 days to understand the Tosfot. And after 40 days, he had a dream with the rabbi, the Baal Tosfot. He told him, they give me permission from the Shamayim to explain you this Tosfot that you did not understand. Okay? So he explained him. Ah, Baruch Hashem, thank you. And now it's clear. The rabbi said, now it's clear. The rabbi was so happy. He went to the Beit HaMidrash. He was so excited to tell his student the answer, the explanation of that Tosfot. You know what happened? He saw the student sitting talking about the Tosfot that for 40 days they could not understand, and suddenly there is a boy. He said, well, we spent 40 days to understand this Tosfot of the rabbi, and I think it's very easy. So the other one said, so the rabbi, he came, he said, what you said, it's easy, not tell me the answer, and he gave him the answer. The answer that the rabbi got in his dream from the Baal Tosfot himself. He was so depressed. He was so... He had a big pain. What's going on? 40 days, I fast. 40 days, I study Torah. For 40 days, we try to understand this Tosfot. And this boy suddenly came just like that and gave an answer. So he couldn't stay. He left Beit HaMidrash. And he went to sleep. And he slept, he had a dream with the Baal Tosfot. He said, tell me, why are you depressed? Why are you not happy? He said, because it's not fair. What do you mean it's not fair? For 40 days, I fast to understand this Tosfot, and suddenly this boy, he understands it like that. So the rabbi told him, the Baal Tosfot, he said, look, I want to teach you something. You know, this Tosfot, that no one could understand it, because it was so strong that no one could understand it. It's like a safe that is closed, is locked, and you need the code to open it. Without the code, you cannot never open this safe. So this Tosfot, this question that you had, there is no answer. But because you fasted 40 days, you opened the safe. You open. Now that you fasted 40 days, now anyone can understand this Tosfot. You were the cause that now anyone in Australia, in America, in Morocco, in Israel, anyone who studied this Tosfot, he will understand it. Up to now, until now, no one could understand it. You see, my friend, the Torah is not only to understand the Torah, and that's it. Bye-bye. The Torah is Amala Shatorabim Be'okotai Telechu. You have to do effort. You know why I finish as excuse me to take out of your time. You know why the Torah said you have to do a lot of effort to study? You know why? By doing effort, you open the code of the Torah for others to understand. Because there is a lot of sodot of Torah, no one can understand them. So no one will understand them, what's going to happen? So how? You. Don't sleep. Sit. Learn. Be'amal. And through that, when you will understand it, everyone in the world will understand it. So Rabotai, this was the problem of the Talmidim of Rabbi Akiva. Those Talmidim, they were good between them. Each one has his own friend. But unfortunately, because they did not do Amal of Torah of other people. Only Amal, it's like if Avidan was my Havota, all my effort was with him. All his effort was with me. If my Havota was Rav Jaker, so he will know my Torah, I will know his Torah, and that's it. What about the others? What about Nimeron? His Torah. What about Yosef? His Torah. So he will keep it for himself. I need to know. But if I go and ask him, I will go to you, I will ask you, you go to each one. Each one will ask the other one. So we will know more and more and more. Baruch Hashem Rabotai, only through all the yeshivot that we have today, Baruch Hashem, in the world, there is more Torah. But if there was less yeshivot, there will be less Torah. Rabbi Hananiah ben Akasha Omer, רצה הקדוש ברוך הוא לזכות את ישראל, לפיכך הרבה להם תורה ומצוות. הקדוש ברוך הוא, he gave us more Torah. Hashem gave us only 5 Torah. He only gave us 5 books. That's it. Look how many books there is. There is millions of books. From where those millions of books came? There was only 5 books. 5 Torah. That's what Hashem gave us. Yes, but because of the amal, because of the effort that we had in the Torah, look the result. The result is, the more you study Torah, marbe Torah, marbe chokma. The more you study Torah, there is more chokma. But don't think on business, you will be more clever. No, you can make mistakes. But more you sit and learn Torah, you will be chacham. Rabotai, Shekadosh Baruch Hu give you bracha v'atzlacha today, don't forget, l'hilulah of Rabbi Meir Hananes, his zichut will be with you, amen.
الحب ده بيت بنتو للولا لسيتو الحب ده بيت بنتو.